Last season, Nicky Reid was arguably Manchester City's most consistent defender, but it's a midfield job again for him today. Reid is in midfield largely because the first choice central defenders are now Kevin Bond and Tommy Caton. Aston Villa had doubts about Colin Gibson, Des Bremner and Eamon Deesey, but are able to field the side that won at Wigan on Tuesday. Ron Saunders could be forgiven a little extra satisfaction today, returning as manager of the league champions to the club which sacked him in 1974 after just 4.5 months in charge of Manchester City. Forward from Evans for Villa and back from Bond, and Francis is onside. Rimmer misjudging the bounce and Francis can't work it in. As Rimmer acknowledges the mistake, Francis shows his disappointment. But it came for Francis and off the outside of the post. One back by Francis from Cowans. A right ball back heel that went for McDonald. Reid, and we'll come here for Hutchison, and what a fine strike too. Rimmer this time equal to it. Cowan's looking to play it early for Morley's speed, and what a fine ball it was too. And Morley can't ease it under Corrigan as the goalkeeper left his line. Now Tueart. Francis looking to turn, then looking to set up Reeves. Hartford, and Hartford a second time, and surely Francis brought it down with his hand and knows that he won't get away with it. Francis again, trying to turn away from Williams, and now facing the goal and looking for a gap that he could exploit, and the gap was filled in the end by Bremner. Francis was determined here to get a shot in of some description. He waited and he waited until he looked. Thought he might be able to curl it inside the far post from his point of view. But Bremner deflected it behind. And finding Morley, Shaw's peeled off to his left. Went through the centre. But here's Shaw, and it's opened up for Gary Shaw. Corrigan half makes the save and McDonald completes the job. He's been asked by his manager to put more devil into his game. Francis, perhaps a touch of the devil from him. The run made here by Bremner, and Hartford has to track back with him. With arriving, so too is Morley, and Hartford concedes the first corner of the second half. Evans' header and the reflexes from Corrigan as Wythe tries to force it in. It was a splendid save. Alan Evans climbed so well to get in a header of genuine power. Corrigan, who could have been forgiven for being cold at the start of the second half, managed to get it up and then claimed it at the second attempt. Now Francis. Still Francis. Reeves is with him if he needs the help, but Rimmer denies him. Trevor Francis, who needs one more goal for 150 in the Football League, might have thought he got it then. Reeves is onside. Evans trying to get back with him, and Reeves prods it wide. Reeves darting to the near post. Put behind by Bremner. Reeves. And it came off Evans. Caton plants it back. Rimmer's in trouble. Tueart goes in and the whistle goes for a free kick to Aston Villa. This time the free kick goes to City. Even though Bremner came off the worst. Blow to the scalp. Reeves. Tueart! Well, Manchester City have worked hard to find a way through. Came from a quickly taken free kick. with the glancing header. Manchester City 1, Aston Villa 0. And Reeves congratulated for his part too. Everyone but Rimmer in the City half, and the supporters of Manchester City felt that Swain handled as he took control then. And that's deflected off Kevin Bond. The shot from Alan Evans. Corrigan with a wise shake of the head. Presenting it to Cowans. Now Shaw. As Villa go hunting the equaliser, and with, should have provided it. Again City in problems of their own making. Taken up here by Gary Shaw. And then with, as Caton missed his kick, went for placement but placed it wide, and that could be so costly for Villa. A hard-fought Manchester City victory over the league champions. The goal by Dennis Tueart and Joe Corrigan, a series of important saves.